speak in English, I hope you can understand most of what I say. So straight away, come to the point. I'll share my experiences with my guru, three incidences which sort of have a deep impact on me. Starting with the first one, now some of you who have been googling a lot would have seen there's a video by Steve Jobs called Connecting Dots. Yeah, it's a lecture that he gave. Hello? Yeah, I guess this is better. So there's a, on the video, there's a lecture that Steve Jobs gave to Stanford University a couple of years back. Okay, it's called Connecting the Dots. What it says is that when life goes on and life happens, you sort of go with it as a part of the wave. But after a few years, you reflect on what happened and you really think that what happened at that time, there is a story that is emerging in life called Connecting the Dots. Just Google up Steve Jobs, Stanford University, in power. So with that as a context, I'll talk about how my experience with my guru went. So if you go chronologically, I first came to Sydney, then I met Ramakrishna, and then he connected me with the guru. But if you look at it from the perspective of connecting the dots, I believe my guru's anugraha was on me before I met Ramakrishna. It was there on me before I met my guru. Primarily because I met Ramakrishna through my guru's son. He was a mate of mine, we were working together in Satyam, and we were just trying to work on a bid and get on with life. That's what you do in a large IT company. And I was doing some puja and Ramakrishna came to visit him, and that's how we got to know him in the rest of the history. So my key message here is, when did I meet my guru? Well, as a shishya, I met him a little bit further down in life. But from an anugraha perspective, I met him the day I landed up in Sydney. That was my first point. Second point is, when I got to meet him, once there was a picture of the yajulu temple, I got a chance. Hello?
I can switch it off and talk.
So I got a chance to visit my company in Hyderabad where I was working, and then subsequently got a chance, there was a havan happening at Jujuru, and it sort of just dates worked out, so you got a chance to sort of be there. I participated in the yajna. There was a havan going on, that other yajna was going on or something else, and I did my swaha for whatever, half an hour, 1 hour, whatever. After that, the samadhi finished. And I don't know, I just do a little bit of small havans here and there, but I was worried, how come you know such a big yajna happening and the samadhi finished? So the thought was there in my mind. The guru being guru, after half an hour, we had a performance appraisal. How did the havan go? Any thoughts, any concerns? I said, yes, some samadhi was over. He said, the samadhi was as per the mathematical formula that we are supposed to have for this kind of havan, for this kind of evening, you have 100 grams of this, 500 grams of that. So people ended up using more of it, it is bound to get completed. So the thought was there in my mind, but my guru made sure that, you know, I got the answer to it towards the end of it as a performance appraisal review kind of question. Third instant. When I met my guru ma was unwell. Okay. She had trouble with the feet. And I realized that, you know, she was unwell. What can you do sitting 100 kilometers, 10,000 kilometers away from that place? You can only pray. So we prayed for her. On a subsequent visit to Hyderabad, okay, I go to my guru's place to meet him and my mate who is his son. I happened to land up on the day on which the Shraddha Puja is going on. She made sure that I sort of get blessings of my guru on that day. That's all that I want to say. Three instances of my engagement with the guru and my experiences. That's it, Ramakrishna. Over to you.
It's Manishi R Dave sharing your experiences with the guru. Ippudu, ఎనిమిది కావస్తుంది కాబట్టి ముందుగా భోజనాలు చేసుకుని తర్వాత మళ్ళీ 8:30కి మళ్ళీ మొదలు పెడతామండి. ఇప్పుడు భోజన కార్యక్రమాలు చేసుకుంటాం.